Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the program. Super Bowl champion, friend to all men, Santana Dotson. Good morning, Santana.
Hey, good morning, fellas. How are we feeling today?
It's a win. We got a win. Snuck one out. Did you?
Yeah, we got the victory.
Yeah, we got the victory, right?
I don't feel great about it. I realize we're just a cornea scratch away from being, you know, 0 for the rest of the season. If our backup guy can't, you know,
make a handoff.
Yeah, make that happen.
Did you see that mess yesterday?
Yeah, and it was a mess.
I mean, it really was
a mess. We're just making a lot more difficult than it has to be.
When you were playing football, when you were wearing number 71 and you're a defensive lineman, a tackle, the toughest position of all, you've told us, right?
No doubt.
No.
Only the most elite.
Right, get to play that position. All right, so when you're playing tackle, if they'd have come to you and said, Santana, get in there, we need you just for one snap to take the snap and make a handoff, could you have done that? Could you have taken the snap, taken your whatever?
Wheeled around.
And handed
the... Shoved the ball into Cedric Benson's gut there.
And got out of the way. Could you have pulled that off?
Yeah, I would like to think I would have been able to hand that ball off. You know, now to his defense, he didn't trip himself. It's not like he stumbled over his own feet, but it did look kind of bad at a very inopportune time.
Oh, that was a huge play. The whole game turned on that.
Yeah, I mean, they scored off of that.
About three plays later, granted, it was a blown defensive assignment. The tackles did their job. It was the secondary that got lost somehow.
Yeah, they dropped the coverage. I mean, you know, like I said earlier, we're just making it a lot harder than it has to be for whatever reason. And hopefully we get all that out of our system before, you know, December, January.
Is it a lack of talent, or are we just, not just doing stupid things?
I think much of the things, I don't know if we learned our lesson from last year. It's like we still aren't very committed to the running game and still are getting gashed defensively, not making them earn everything defensively.
Well, Cedric carried the ball yesterday for 18 times for 84 yards. That's probably more production than we've had, in the last year or two out of a running back?
Yeah,
that is a step in the right direction. I like what I'm seeing from Cedric. We just need to do a lot more of it. That'll make it easier for Aaron.
You got to set up the pass with the run. Then you got to throw long every now and then just to keep everyone honest so they don't just come up and cheat on the run or the short pass. I don't know if there's time to do all these things. You know, because first of all, you got to get 10 yards and move the chains.
Yeah, it's funny how the two of them go together. So, you know, I just think it'll make it easier for the offensive line, too, because we still have an offensive line that's trying to gel. So, you know, it's a step in the right direction. We'll take that victory, and let's just take one and grow with it.
Yeah, that would have been a crushing defeat coming on the heels of what happened to us on Monday night. But the honeymoon is over.
And another bad call.
Yeah.
And another bad call in the fourth quarter.
Right, the fumble that was clearly a fumble that they said was down by contact when he was still standing upright when the ball was flying out in front of him.
Yeah.
What, are they just rusty?
Yeah, a little bit rusty. But luckily that one didn't come back to bite us.
It almost did.
It could have.
Yeah. And then, okay, I don't know if there's a heads up or something you yell in the secondary when a ball is up for grabs, but we had two guys both going for the ball, and I understand that because it's a...
Oh, when they clunked into each other?
It's a scramble at that point, but is there some sort of protocol when the ball is up like that to call for it or something?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, really the guy, the safety that was the deepest should have seen the cornerback going for the ball and allowed him to catch an interception. But, you know, things happen and the game is so fast.
Well,
so
it was,
they'll fix it as they go.
It was tipped. I mean, I can see when you're going after a ball that's flying cleanly through the air, but after it's tipped, it's sort of like it's going to screw everything up. Right?
I mean, because
you don't know what direction it's going to, and your momentum is going one way, and the ball could be ricocheting off another.
Plus, it's
right. You're fighting to make a play. So, you know, we'll give him a little grace on that one.
All right. You said you were at the Houston game yesterday. We have them coming up in 2 weeks, and they look awfully good, don't they?
Yes, they don't have many chinks in their armor right now. They have an outstanding running game and exciting defense, playing some of the best defense right now of anybody in the NFL. And, you know, they've got an outstanding wide receiver, and they've got Matt Schaub spreading the ball around. So they're looking good. They're definitely looking good.
But we go to Indianapolis this week. That's a team that, they have some work to do.
Yes, they definitely, they've got a rookie quarterback, and Andrew Luck looks pretty well. He looks good. They're still a young team trying to get things together. So this is one of those victories that we got to have and try to get consistent with everything we're doing.
How far ahead did you look on the schedule when you were playing? Next week or a couple weeks out, or were there games that you looked forward to?
No. I mean, victories are so hard to get in the NFL. You got to go week to week. You don't look down the line at all. You may look at the schedule, during the preseason or in the off season when it first comes out, like this is going to be a big game or this is a great Monday night game matchup and things like that. But when the season starts, you're definitely 6-7 days out. No more, no less.
Well, that Houston game is a Sunday night game. That's the game of the week.
Yeah, next week is like, what, the first time they're not in some national spotlight. It's just a noon.
It will be our first noon kickoff of the season. Is that a problem?
Yeah,
that's
what happens when you're media darlings. You don't get many 12 o'clock kickoffs.
Do you pay attention to what the announcers say, like Troy Aikman and Joe Buck yesterday? Because Brian said, I think Troy Aikman hates the Packers.
I think Troy Aikman is an anti-Packer.
And there's other people who texted in and have said the same thing. I don't know. I listen to him and I go, he's just being objective, isn't he?
I can kind of tell there's a sense of, anti-Packer there.
Yeah, it's probably from all those years being the Cowboy quarterback. When the Cowboys and Packers were vying for...
He beat the... I hate to say this, Santana. He won those games pretty regularly.
Right. There's nothing for him to be wound up about, but I think he's just got some old tooth marks on him.
Yeah, and I think when he looks at the game, he may be pretty objective, but you got to look at those championship teams he was on as a Cowboy. He's kind of looking for those similarities, which, again, would be outstanding running game. And some consistent defense. So those are the kind of things that he points to all the time.
He's got to do a lot of talking, and it's unscripted. Character, his feelings are going to come out.
But if he doesn't, if you think he doesn't like the Packers, what do you think the Giants and Redskin games are like? Are like that he calls?
I never listened to him, so he could very well be just the same way. I think he probably is.
All right. Are you getting ready for Halloween down there? We are into October now, Santana.
Well, the seasons are finally changing. I've got 60 degrees here. Finally, it's cooling off.
Are you enjoying it?
Oh, yeah, I'm enjoying it.
If you want some cooler weather, there's...
It's going to be 67 here today.
Yeah, it's going to be warm through Thursday, and then it gets a little chilly this weekend. I think the highs are in the 50s. If you want some of that, you're always welcome.
Yeah. Are y'all taking a trip down to the pumpkin patch, or what are y'all doing for Halloween?
Pumpkin patch.
Last year, my Halloween decorations, I looked at them and thought, well, these things are done. These things are cooked. This is the last year. So I got to get some new stuff.
Oh, you need, okay.
And those little cauldrons that blow air up through them. It looks like a fire, but it's just...
Put on quite a show over there, don't you?
It's just like fabric with a little yellow light on it. Yeah.
What do you have out in the yard?
You got all the bells and whistles. Huh?
What do you put out in the yard?
Not much. I've got one more. My youngest is six. So, she's trying to decide between a princess. She said a princess last week instead of a witch.
Yeah.
I'll be glad. I'm the one that has to do the walking through the neighborhood.
So do you have a vampire cape? Do you have a vampire cape?
No, I don't have a vampire cape. Oh. I had like a wolf mask. It scared one of my older kids, so they made me retire that. It was kind of a gothic looking wolf that I kind of liked it.
Really?
But yeah.
I wish you'd get a vampire. Yeah. You know, they're all the rage, the vampires. You need some teeth, cape, maybe slick your hair back like Eddie Munster.
Draw a widow's peak down a little bit on your forehead. It's worth thinking about.
So you're liking the vampire.
I like it for you. You've got vampire written all over you.
Do I really?
Yeah, yeah. You don't see a lot of really big vampires either.
No, usually little and skinny.
Right. Usually I think you need to bring big to the vampire world. You know, you need to suck a couple of people dry as opposed to just...
That's interesting you said that. You know, a long time ago I went to a masquerade party or one of those Halloween parties that one of my teammates had, and I was a vampire. And I also had, like, a Rick James wig, like one of those long Jerry Curl wigs.
You were a super freak vampire.
Yeah, right. I was like a super pimp vampire. When I talked to him and his wife, they still say that was the most outstanding costume of everybody at the party.
There you go.
Is there a picture of it?
Oh, you gotta ask them if they have a picture, and I'll send it to you.
I'd love to see that. I'd love to put that on our website.
See, I could tell it about you just because I know you. You're a vampire.
Just
a vampire.
For the record, we can't let our guard down just because we're going to Indianapolis. Wasn't it your team that went to Indianapolis in the Super Bowl season and lost to the Colts?
Yep. Yes.
You had to bring that up.
Yeah, because you can never let your guard down. Never, ever.
Never, ever.
Let that be a reminder. All right, Santana. Have a good week.
All right, fellas.
All right.
I'll talk to y'all next week. Have a good one.
All right.
And a good day to you.